Hello, from one chapter 8, video number 15, page number 12. Discernment, scattering of light, 光散射. How I know? Google. Maybe wrong, 可能错, 不是我的错. Google, 不是我的错. Next, 光散射, 什么叫光散射? Scattering of light occurs when light is deflected. 被反射 in all the direction 重点在这边 by the cloud or maybe particle in the air 什么意思呢? So scattering of light occurs when light is diffracted 当光被反射 in all the direction by the cloud or particle in the air 它被我们的云被我们空气中的 particle 乱乱的反射 这种就叫光散射 So what's the difference between the diffractions and the scattering of light?Diffraction 光反射是美美的，它这边来，它这边反射出去，对不对？中间有一条 normal， so this is what we call diffraction 光反射。But sunshine in our air， 在我们的空气中 ，it contains a lot of particle， it contains a lot of particle， 里面有很多很多粒的 particle。So when the light travel through the particle， the light will be diffracted。Into all the direction, 它的光呢被反射 Into all the direction, 乱乱的被反射乱乱的被分开 So 这种情况就叫光散射它就是乱乱的被反射了差别就在这边 OK? 光散射 Now, how is the experiment? I prepare experiment to prove that light can be scattered 光可以被散射At the beginning, I having the distilled water inside the beaker. 在 beaker 里面我放 distilled water. And now, my eyes is here. Toast light is here. I on the toast light, 我开我的手电筒. And now, what I can see at the end of the beaker. 在 beaker 的对面呢我看到什么东西呢 I see nothing like just transparent, 透明光光这样子罢了白白光光了 So this is what happened at the beginning. 刚刚开始的时候蒸馏水罢了我看到的就是白色的光经过那个水水清澈见底对不对 That's all.And now I add some milk powder inside. 现在我放一些奶粉下去。I add some milk powder inside. I just pour the milk 啦。还是你泡好了也不用紧啦。你把它倒进去 and stir, 搅搅几下。After the milk powder add into the water, it becomes the milky water, 对不对？它变成了 milky water, 好像奶水这样子啊。And now you on the toast light for the second time. 你现在再开手电筒第二次。And what's your observation? 你的观察是什么呢？ From the side of the beaker, now you can see something like bluish white color.白色不过白中带蓝呢 So bluish white color 白中带蓝对我来讲是白中带蓝的它是白色不过它的白色呢有蓝色的底在里面呢 So bluish white 蓝白的颜色了 But if you move your eyes go to the opposite side 帮你把眼睛呢搬去对面的时候 You can see another color 你看到另外一种颜色就是红白的颜色白红的颜色 red color 奇怪旁边看蓝色对面看红色当然不是很红啦白色的红啦 OK So why 为什么会这样子呢 So this is a phenomena that we call light scattering 这种现象就叫光散射光乱乱的被反射了 But why it can be happen 为什么会这样子呢 I tell you 我告诉你了 huh?So our light, 阳光啊，我们的能见光，眼睛能看到的光 ，actually is an electromagnetic wave， 它们是一种电磁波。所以 we call 光波，对吗？光也叫光波。So 光就是一种电磁波。But different color light, actually they're having different wavelength， 不一样颜色的光呢，有不一样的波长。明白我的意思？不知道。光就是一种波来的所以叫光波不过不一样颜色的光有不一样的波长它们的波的长度不一样 For example, red color light okay, You can copy on your notes、啊、你可以抄在你的 notes 如果你没有这些东西自己加下去、啊、For example, red color light actually is a long wave 红色的光是长波就是一个波动啊 ，up and down， 上了又下，啊又上回来了，这样子 sang 又下又上回来一个波动那这样子叫做一个波动 so up and down and up again 一个波动啊上又下 so for red color line actually is a long wave 它是长波 so 一个波动呢很长、so 红色的光它走动是这样走的很长 so 这种叫长波But compared to the violet color, 跟紫色做比较呢 ,violet color will be different, 紫色是不一样的。But for violet color, it will be different. Violet color actually is a short wave, 它是短波。红色是长波紫色它是短波它一个波动很短吧 ,up and down 很短 ,up and down 很短红色很长的 ,okay? So,So what's the difference between the long wave and short wave? 长波跟短波有什么差别呢? Okay? So now they say I'm making some particle in the air. 现在我在空气中呢做一些 particle. Sorry, I'm making some particle in the air. So the new particle will be appear. 它自己出来了。有没有看到很多一粒一粒的东西? Wait for me, 等我做 particle, 一粒一粒的东西。So in our air, it contains a lot of dust, 有灰尘 it contains a lot of air particle. So when the white light pass through the air, what happened? Red color light just move like this. 红色的光呢 because of a long wave, 因为它长波it will be less collide together with the air particle. 它比较少撞到空气的 particle. Mm, 对不对 Compared to the violet, 它怎样走路的你看啊So violet color, because of the short wave, you collide with a lot of air particles, so the violet will be diffracted, violet and blue, 蓝光跟紫光它们这样子走路短波 so 一直撞到空气 so they will be diffracted into the different direction,被反射去任何的一个方向这种就叫光散射了 OK Now we go back to our experiment 我们再回去我们的实验了 So when you add the milk powder into the water it contains a lot of particle When the white light pass through the milky water What happened? The blue color together with the violet 蓝光紫光呢它们就这样子因为它们短波撞到 particle So they will be diffracted away, 被反射出来了。所以旁边看蓝色比较多。And where is the violet? 紫色呢? Our eyes actually is not very sensitive to the violet. 人类的眼睛呢对紫色不是很敏感。所以当蓝跟紫一起来的时候你看到蓝比较多的紫色你不敏感。紫外你看不到紫外线呢你看不到了。Understand? So blue color light will be observed.Will be observed from the side, lah. 因为蓝光在半路的时候一直喷出来，叭叭叭叭叭叭叭叭叭叭叭叭。And at the end, 到最后的时候啊 when you put your eyes here, you just can see the red white, because all the blue color scattered away. 蓝光被散射掉了，只有红色呢 can pass through the milky water. The red color can pass through the milky water and finally entering your eyes. 难怪啦，对面只剩下红色，其他的被散射掉、反射掉了。Understand?红色才能只有红色能走过去了 Or we look at the experiment 我们看看它的实验吧
Hi, this is Kate with the St. Louis Science Center Science Off Center team here with another fun at-home experiment that you can do Today we're going to talk about sunsets a little bit about light refraction All you have to do is have about fourth of a cup of milk or more, a flashlight, and I have 2 gallons of water in a clear plastic container. That's all you need to get started. All right, so you start with clear water. You can see that when I have a flashlight on the side of my container, you don't see any particles in my water.It's clear, it's pretty clean, but when I add a fourth of a cup of milk in there, what I'm adding are some impurities, some proteins and fats, stir that up, that will cause the light to refract differently. Alright, so I've turned off the lights to give the difference in color a more dramatic effect. Take your flashlight, put it to the side of the container.
Okay, so do you notice that? If you look at the beaker or the container from the side 从旁边看, the color will be bluish white. 白中带蓝,蓝白蓝白的颜色,对不对? So this is what happened.
And you'll notice that it's a bluish type of light. This would be like if the sun were at high noon or straight up in the sky. Now take your flashlight and look at the beam straight.
But if you move to the opposite side of the beaker, 跑去对面看, you can see the red color, 你看到红色红色对不对? Okay, why? 蓝光短波。这个是我多教你的啦，你不要写在考试，因为你不需要会啦。红光长波，它可以跑过去啦。So this is what we call.
You'll notice that it's a warmer color, a yellow, an orange, maybe even a red if you...
Okay, settle. So, light scattering, 光散射. So now I settle some of your problem. Why all our car, no matter how much is your car, all the car tail lights, 车的尾灯, all of them must be red color. Or maybe having BMW, or maybe you having Jaguar, 对不对? Why you should follow the red color? 为什么你的尾灯一定红色?你可以换其他颜色,蓝色啊。So why must be red?一定有原因的，对不对？很简单。During the rainy day, or haze, or maybe, 还有什么 day 啊 ？Rainy day, haze, 蒙蒙的时候啊 ，smoky day, 烟烟的时候。So red light, because of long wave, 因为它长波 ，it can pass through a lot of particle, 它可以经过很多的 particle. So if you look at the, photo here, 你看到红光最明，对不对？So red light can travel very far because of the long wave. 它可以经过很多的 particle 没有撞到。So red light clearer 啦，比较光。Compared to blue 啊，蓝色没有用的。蓝色 because of the short wave, 它短波，它走路的时候撞到东西，半路已经碰到晚去了，你看不到了，明白吗 ？So this is the reason red color light for the tail car. Red car tail lights, 车的尾灯全部都是红色的。Okay.Next. So our next item will be, I'll tell you, why does the sky appear blue at the midday? 为什么下午中午的时候天空是蓝色? And our sky turned to red color in the evening. 在傍晚的时候它变成红色。什么原因呢?不知道。So see you in the next video. 下一个 video 再见。拜拜。谢谢你。